difficult to show a few years ago the effect of glue ear and ear infections on language learning, because some children seem to learn fine even though they had a history of two or three ear infections or glue ear. But some recent research that's been done is starting to show a much closer relationship between ear infections and language development. And essentially what they're starting to see is that some children seem to be more prone to auditory processing disorders. And if they have glue ear or if they have ear infections, that can exacerbate the effect of the auditory processing problem. But another issue is that we're also starting to understand, Patricia Kuhl and other neuroscientists who've been studying language development are showing how important the amount of language is to a young child. And if a child has glue ear, or if a child has an ear infection, they have a slight hearing loss. It's called a conductive hearing loss. It's about 30% hearing loss. And that hearing loss interferes with the amount of sounds they're hearing. And the amount of sounds is what the brain is using. It's looking at statistics, looking at how many sounds, how many times does this sound occur in this child's life? And if suddenly that sound doesn't occur very often because a child can't hear it, then that child isn't going to learn the sounds of the language as easily. And if they don't learn the sounds of the language as easily, that affects language development. It also is going to affect reading development. It's also going to affect later ability to discriminate sounds in noise. So learning in school is difficult. So it has all sorts of effects that are more subtle, but we're starting to actually be able to quantify those.